Hey y'all, this is Ford Mustang 98 guy here, and today, let's take an in-depth look at this 1998 Toyota Corolla DX. And this can be a full in-depth tour of the Corolla. We'll start the engine, show it off, go some foreign specification, get an exhaust clip, show you a bunch of the features on the inside as well as the outside. So, without further ado, just going to start it up, let it run. It's a dark gray exterior with gray cloth interior. This one just about has 2,195 kilometers. That's just my iPod there. It's hooked up to a tape adapter at the moment. Very nice. Very smooth power steering. Hand brakes on. Comes with the 4-speed automatic transmission with overdrive and low gear selection. Not bad. So, let's crank it on the headlights. Hazards. Manual windows. And we're gonna check out the exterior, shall we? No. I'm checking out the outside. 1998 was the last year of this Corolla generation until 1998. 1999 came, Toyota started making the car different. Everything works on it, I guess. The Toyota emblem right there. Tires, hubcaps. They're wet because it's been cleaned up. Unfortunately, the door handle's broken, but actually that piece broke, so it actually still works. Tony, stay here. Tony, stay here.
Well, if you're going back, thank you very much.
Pop the fuel cap. Locks in place, place to put your fuel cap. Third brake light located right here. And your exhaust. Alright, we're gonna pop the hood. Okay. Where is it? Hey, wanna do it? There she be. It's a 4-cylinder. It's a V4. I really don't know what motor it is, so don't ask me what it is. Your battery right there. Your windshield washer fluid right there. Alrighty. Set it up. The Corolla is a pretty great car, but it's not bad for a small vehicle. You can see this one's a pretty basic model. You have your manual windows right here, your manual mirrors, your lock right there, storage down below. The full manual driver's seat, manual recliner right here, your trunk release, your fuel cap release, as I showed you the fuel cap earlier, and it does have a tilt steering wheel. Alrighty, now let's go ahead and see how she revs. Gotta love that sound. Hey, is the muffler cracked or something? Alright. Hey, do the exhaust. Exhaust. You wanna hold it or something? Come. I'm gonna make the exhaust.
No.
Put your phone in the pocket. Exhaust clip. I'm doing the exhaust. No, I'm videotaping. Okay.
What do you want me to do?
The exhaust.
What exhaust? What do you want me to do?
You have to hold the camera. Okay.
Come
down. Don't push anything, okay? Hold it.
Yeah, I got it.
Don't cover the fingers, okay? Don't push any buttons, okay? Okay, leave it like that. Shh, Mike. Stay. Huh? No, steady, come. Thank you. Alright, now I'm going to check out the inside, okay? Alright, we're going to shut it up. Easy to use climate control. Different zones. Temperature. Circulation. Your front defrost, as well as rear defrost. Air conditioning. As well as fan speed. Leave it on a bit. AM FM radio, as you can see here. It's currently connected to my iPod at the moment, so. So we're gonna just play a song here. And. Actually hooked up to our tape adapter right now. That's my camera case. The handbrake. Cigarette lighter. Cup holders. Vents in the center, your digital clock, hazard switch, manual dimming rearview mirror, broken, see you have your equalizer settings, your bass, treble, AM FM tape, and your 6 preset stations.
Over here, you have your headlight controls, turn signals. Over here, you have your wiper controls. Pretty nice car. Alright, your vents are over here. Little storage cubby right there. Alrighty. Alright, it's gonna shut it off. Whoa. Now we're gonna check out the back seat. My iPod works. It works.
What?
You can use it for the tape adapter. Manual window switch. Seat belt. Back seat is a little roomy back here. I'm about 5'10", about something like that. And my head's just about, it's barely touching the ceiling. Because I am a taller passenger, as you can see. Seatbelt right here. Manual window switch. Alright, let's go check out the rest of the vehicle, shall we? Actually, I can pop the trunk from here. There we go. It is a small car and it has a roomy trunk. It's a little dirty, but it's okay. Yeah, this thing has rust on it, as you can see. Not good enough. Caps there. Manual window switch, storage there. Move this out of the way. Even has same thing on the back. Good size glove box. The Toyota Corolla. For no one is trying to buy a vehicle like this, you can always depend on your Toyota, that's for sure. Alright, now we'll start up with the door closed. Now before we end the video, I'll start it up with the door closed. Stupid key. Shut that shit off. Pretty nice. There's your release for tape adapter right there. Actually, I think it doesn't have all-wheel drive.
Alright.
Kill it. Let's cut the engine off. Well guys, hope you enjoyed this in-depth look at the 1998 Toyota Corolla. So stay tuned next time, there's a lot more where that came from. Take care, everybody.